your vocabs. Okay? Alright, so we go first with the collaborative advantage. Collaboration and collaborate. When we say you collaborate between two parties. The business party and the other one lah, as a businesses. So what is it, the advantages of collaboration? You get to manage the relationship with your key customers. In your businesses, in your business, you need to determine who are your key customers. Okay? So dalam business kita tidak ada hanya satu customer saja. It's very impossible for us to have only one customer. We serve a lot of customers. Yeah? Similarly with the university lah. Kalau university ni, you are the customers. You are the key customers of the universities. Your parents are also the customers. The other government agencies are also customers. The industry are also customers. And there are many others. But we have to understand who exactly our key customers. Yeah? Because key customers ni lah yang akan give profit to the organization specifically. Alright? Develop innovative strategies with alliance partners. So what kind of innovation strategy that you would like to develop or you would like to create between your partner as well as your organization? Okay. This is the relationship between buyer and seller. You got to see we have previously the traditional exchanges. Traditional before the technology lah basically. Yeah. So before the technology, everything goes manually. You have to go to the organization to have a meeting and so on and so forth. And the documentation is done manually. Semuanya is done traditionally. Yeah? But once we move to the value-added exchanges and collaborative exchanges, the strategies will become very different. Yeah? And now with the advance of the technology, lagilah you got to have a very advanced kind of collaboration between your partners. And kalau dulu nak ada meeting pun, you have to go to the mana-mana tempat lah to set up. But now, without going anywhere, you can just do meetings online and so on and so forth. Okay. Of relationship here, okay, kita sini ni ada explanation here. Centers on timely exchange of basic products and highly competitive market price. So that's a different when you have when we are moving towards a modern kind of relationship. Yeah. Okay, the transactions are autonomous. Yeah? So basically, previously, not only previously, lah, sekarang pun you can do autonomous kind of transaction. Autonomous, it means that you have the autonomy, you have the power to decide. Although you have a collaboration between the other parties, but the other parties got to decide themselves. As I gave example last time, the difference between university and school. So the school, they cannot make their own decision. They have to go to the kementerian. The kementerian must make decision for them. But at the university, although the university belongs under Higher Education Ministry, however, the university, they have a say when they want to decide on anything. Okay? So university ni dia lebih berautonomi lah. Dia lebih exercise the power of the decision. Sekolah dia tak boleh buat decision sendiri. Dia nak pergi barang, they cannot just simply go to the shop and buy. They have to go through the kementerian to get the approval from kementerian, baru dia boleh pergi barang for the school, even for the infrastructure. But at the university level, we have our own decision. We can decide to buy. We don't have to go and seek for the approval from Higher Education Ministry. You faham the difference between autonomy. Okay. Value-adding exchanges fall between transactional and collaborative exchange. Value-adding basically is valuable to your organization as well as valuable to your parties that you have a business with. Okay? So in order to have a value when you have a collaboration with the other businesses, you need to understand customer needs and their changing requirements, tailor the firm's offerings to those needs, and then provide continuing incentive that promote repeat businesses. Yeah. So kalau kita nak ada value dengan company yang lain, we have to understand each other. As I mentioned many times, that the needs and wants of the businesses is always changing. Okay? Sama dengan environment yang kita ada ni, sentiasa berubah-ubah. Even our needs and preferences is also changing. Last time, we like this. But now, we don't like the things that we like in the past. Okay? So, those changes, kita kena aware of with that. Okay? Similarly, with last time, the students do not really like online classes, for example, but now they prefer online classes because it's very relaxed and they are free to do anything they want during online classes, kan? Dulu tak mahu ni online class ni masa awal-awal pandemic dulu. Nobody wants, tak faham lah, ibu lah ini. But now everyone is looking for online classes, okay? Because you know the company, the enjoyment of the online classes already. Okay? You pun dah boleh manipulate yourself pun during the online classes. Those kind of things that will have an effect on the businesses, right? The changing in terms of the environment, the changing in terms of the political parties, politics, the economics, the social and so on and so forth. Itu semua akan mengakibatkan perubahan kepada everything, yeah, related. Okay, and then provide continuing incentives. Incentives ni semua orang suka. Eh, kalau bagi bonus, everyone love bonus. Extra holidays. Some of you ada yang ambil extra holidays, kan? Tak mau datang lagi sebab hari Khamis cuti, hari Jumaat cuti, Sabtu cuti, Ahad cuti. So, berapa-berapa? You punya raya minggu ni dah. Minggu ni tahun ni, raya 3 minggu cuti, kan? Yeah? Alright, so next one is the characteristics of relationship. Stop now. You can look at your book there. On page 53. So what is it? The difference between transactional exchange and collaborative exchange. For the transactional exchange, the availability of the alternative is many alternatives. Yeah. But for collaborative exchange, you have a few alternatives. In terms of transactional, you tidak ada collaboration. Yeah. You do not have a collaboration between one party. So the relationship is not really there. Yeah. But for the transactional, you can get transactional between any parties that you would like. That's why they say you have many alternatives, yeah? As compared to the collaborative. You know, you collaborate dengan orang, so you punya preferences ataupun you punya keutamaan adalah with the parties that you collaborate first. Okay? But for the transactional, you don't have collaboration. That's why you are given a lot of alternatives that you can choose from. Supply market is very stable. This one is not stable. By the time importance of the purchase and so on and so forth, the other point is still you can read it in detail in the textbook. Okay, switching cost. Switching. Yeah? How do you switch? Bertukar. Change. Switching cost is very expensive to the organization. As much as possible, the organization, they don't want the customer to switch or to change to the other alternative. Because switching costs will be very expensive to the organization. Expensive in a way that you have to find out a new collaborators. Similar way, customer lah. The customers, we do not really want the customers to change from one brand to the other brand. So some of us, perhaps we are very loyal to one particular brand for one thing, yeah? And there are people people who would like to change every time. Contoh kalau you pergi ubat gigi, for example, there are customers who are very loyal to one particular brand daripada kecil sampai lagi tua sampai ke anak-anak cucu dia. Brand tu sajalah yang dia akan pergi. But there are customers who likes to switch every time. Minggu ni dia beli yang ini lah, bulan depan dia beli ini lah, because they like to try. So there are customers like that. But in the business, we try as much as possible to retain the business partners, supaya kita tidaklah incur the switching cost in the future. Okay, the investment in the business, it will include money, of course. Money is the investment. Whenever we say about investment, people will associate investment with money. But there are other things that will influence or affect the investment. Here, for example, the people. The training costs, the equipment, procedures and process, people. People in the organization is also a switching cost to the organization. People ni maksudnya adalah staff lah, the employees. The employees in the organization. So why is it a cost to the organization? Because to train employees, it requires cost. Each of the employees, they have to go to a training to make sure that they increase in their knowledge, they increase in their skills and so on and so forth. So you dah spend a lot to your staff. Jadi you tak nak lah staff you ni akan pergi ke tempat-tempat lain, because they are the expert. Once they become your staff, you send them for training and then they become the expert. So expert tu kita nak retain lah dalam organisasi kita as much as possible. Training cost is also very expensive. So if you work later in the organization, your employer will send you to a training, basically. A training to improve your skills, to improve your knowledge, to improve here and there. So daripada training cost itulah you akan improve yourself, memantapkan lagi diri, memantapkan lagi your knowledge and so on and so forth. And once you become more knowledgeable, so you can berpindah randah lah kepada organisasi yang offer lebih baik dan sebagainya. Okay. So bila you become a value to the organisation will keep you. Kalau organisation tu suka dengan you, so kalau you have an intention to move to the other organisation, dia akan counter balik your salary. Jadi you kena make sure you expert lah, expert and have more skills and so on and so forth, supaya you become a value to the organization and value to yourself as well, right? Okay, customer perceive more risk when they purchase products important to their operation, buy from less established suppliers and buy technical complex products. So these products. A very complex product is also very risky, because risky in terms of operating, in terms of maintenance and so on and so forth. And also when you want to buy a product, you need to make sure that you buy from an established supplier, very stable supplier. Jangan supplier yang baru dilantik dan dijadilah macam apa yang ada dekat negara kita sekarang lah. Supplier-supplier yang dilantik semuanya, some of it because of the crony, because of the cable, sebenarnya kita tidak ada pengetahuan and so on and so on. So look at our building tu, tak sampai 10 tahun dah banyak dah sana sini not functioning. So we don't want that lah. So it is more risky, risky in terms of you are losing your money, risky in terms of you will be dealing with your other customers. So bila you have this kind of this product and services in your organization, so your customer point will no longer believe in you. So they will change. They will change to the other suppliers, or they will change to the other resources. Alright? Any question? Thank you. Of Huawei experience, know-how, and its ability to improve customers' time to market. Product quality and delivery performance is very important for the collaborative relationship as well. You want to have a good product in terms of the quality. So apa-apa sahaja pun yang nak beli, mestilah you are looking into the quality of the product. Product yang berkualiti ni, they are very expensive, but at the same time, they are very long lasting. As compared to are buying product yang very cheap and not having a good quality. So normally, the product with a good quality, it will be associated with a good price. So but now, people are associating expensive price to the social status as well. So the expensive the product is, the higher your social status will be. Kalau dalam marketing is like that. Macam you beli iPhone lah. Some of you buy iPhone not because of the iPhone itself. You buy it, the first thing you buy it because of the social status. Because it's very expensive, kan? So you nak ambil gambar, you ambil gambar dengan iPhone biasa pun boleh, kan? Tapi you nak do iPhone. Why? Because of the social status lah. In terms of the quality, so I don't know about the iPhone. Katanya iPhone is very fragile in terms of dia punya battery. Tak. Okay. Battery okay, tak panas.